About a year ago, Asa Farai decided to do something about the disappearing native Bahraini frogs and terrapins. Their natural habitat is eroding day by day, and the threat of their extinction is very real. Being the curator of birds and reptiles at Larian Sanctuary, just south of the Bahrain International Circuit, he took matters into his own hands by creating a mini-environment at the Larian, starting with a small water-filled trough and a few water plants inside one of the rooms available to him. He then introduced some frogs into the facility and nurtured them. A few weeks later, he was rewarded by seeing some tadpoles. They've started to breed. In the meantime, Asa was busy constructing an outside enclosure so that the newer environment resembled more closely the frog zone. He put some mature frogs in there and again was rewarded by them breeding quite quickly. He has now introduced them into a much bigger pond where Bahrainis visitors can walk among the reeds and sit by a small waterfall he constructed and observe and enjoy what is their heritage of old. An animal that Asa has diligently worked to protect so that future generations of Bahrainis will recognize a small and alive part of their heritage. This is an informal interview and walkabout I was privileged to conduct with Asa when he shared with me some of his efforts and the Larian's frogs and terrapins area which he has constructed and worked on. I started by asking Asa, why this conservation effort?
اللي هم يعيشون فيها هاي الكريترز المخلوقات اللي يعيشون فيها بدأت في النهاية من خلال أسباب معروفة كلنا نعرفها يعني التطور العمراني والأمور هذه فبيئتها انقرضت تقريبا على وشك الانتهاء حسنا أنه يجب نحن نحمي هذه المخلوق لأن هذه يشكل طبعاً من تراثنا، تراث البحرين.
مين أول شيء خلينا الأمهات؟ عقب ما حصلنا البودنايبة، عقب تقريباً بأربع خمسة أيام نقلنا الأمهات إلى مكان أكبر أغلق، روح نشوفها الحين.
السلاحف البحرينية والضفادع البحرينية وكذلك اللي مكملين لهم اللي هو يسمونه الحراسيم او العفاطي او المولي يعني البيئه مشابهه تماما للبيئه اللي يعيشون فيها البيئه البحرينيه فيها الريد الناعم فيها اللي هو النوع الحشائش اللي تنمو من الالقاع وتسوي نوع الظل او تلاحظ في ظل الحين هم الحشاش يسوون الظل في الكريترز قاعد يستخدمه اللي هو مثل الموليس والضفادع وهم سلاحف في متخششين تحت يحتمون من اي بريدتر ثاني ومن الحراره في الصيف
Talking to Asa Farai, the curator of the Bird Sanctuary and Larian Wildlife Park in Zahir. It is quite amazing actually coming here to see what they've done. My primary visit is due to an article that appeared in one of the papers yesterday about Asa personally trying to salvage the terrapins and the frogs of Bahrain, which are bordering on extinction. I was quite amazed actually when I've seen, I'm very thankful for Asa for doing this for us, for protecting our environment and for expanding the horizons and also contributing to the tourism industry in Bahrain as well. What are the next steps, Asa? Are you going to reintroduce them into their natural habitat again?
For the time being, as we know, the reason why we bring these creatures and look after them still there. I mean, the hazard is still there. So till the hazard is finished and create another environment or place for these creatures, which where they can live and they can extend their life. Till that time, we cannot reintroduce any of them.
Do we have any other endangered species?
We have the bulbul variety, cheetah, bulbul, and others, bears, hoopoe, especially the white cheetah bulbul. We are having problems with people and also lack of their environment as well as the folks. We look after the bulbul. It is very important there.
What plans do you have to rescue these other creatures?
From the publicity side of it and from protecting by announcing and stop kids from having taking their eggs or the chicks from the nest and sell them in the market, or we try to reduce the number of the crows, which they also compete. I mean, crows and the other birds, which are not native to the country, they compete with these native birds, and especially these birds, small birds. They compete them with in their food, their diet, and they destroy their nests and they eat their chicks. So we try to reduce the number of those birds which are affecting the bulbuls.
Is there any legal protection for endangered species in Bahrain?
There is some, but we are going to increase it, and it is it's come in the newspaper, and we have four inspectors, and a number of inspectors which they go to the markets, especially the local markets, and checking to implement those rules.
Mr. Thank you very much for your time. It's been a pleasure meeting you. And I think you're doing an excellent work for Bahrain and for the natural environment within it, as well as the Gulf in total as well.
Thank you very much.
Shukran jazeelan.